All right, we're going to talk a little about the program structure, scope, and objectives. I think this will bring a little more clarity to your question about some of the training components and different things like that. And then Kirk and Joan Ring will talk a lot about the training probably this afternoon. You're going to be real bored listening to us all day today. The practicals tomorrow will make it a lot more fun. So, all right. How the FIDO program is structured, there are four primary sections, and then there are numerous subsections within the guide. And remember, it's a recommended guide. I stress that again. The primary sections are summary administration, training program elements, forms, and references. The first major section is called summary administration, and it's got a subsection in there that's called the program summary. Within this program summary, it contains the guidance documents that provide the information as far as the need for the FIDO-based program, or FIDO investigative-based program. It just gives a little bit of a history. It gives a kind of a abstract of the program and some benefits to the program. Within that program summary, there are several subsections. There's an introduction, scope and objectives, statistical data, basically the same statistical data that I quoted to you from NIFLIS, a section about cost benefit. Sometimes it's all about money. You know, if you can save some taxpayers money and show that a FIDO program has a strong cost benefit, you know, that's part of it. Section on quality control, document control, management oversight, and measurements of effectiveness. You want the program to be effective, there's no reason to implement it. What I've done is, for my presentation here, I've just pulled out certain sections just to kind of give you a little bit of flavor. You'll have plenty of time to look at the FIDO program and see what you think. But section about cost benefit. There's some criteria in there to measure success in providing, the criteria to measure success in providing any analytical service includes the time of provision of those services. The delay in laboratory analytical examination is perpetuated by an extensive controlled substance case backlog and overburdens resources has compounded the problem immensely. There's different information within the section about cost benefit that just hopefully will spark some conversation, some communication about how this program could be of cost benefit to not only the laboratory, but then the judicial and also to law enforcement. As it says, the proper implementation operation of the FIDO program can have a significant impact in the reduction of case backlogs and improve utilization of limited resources. What you will hear from Jay, and I don't want to step on his toes or anything, but what you will hear from him is after they got their FIDO program up and running, utilized it for a couple years, saw the reduction in their case backlog within controlled substances, they were able to use, I think if I remember, two FTEs, full-time equivalent positions, and convert them from controlled substances over to DNA, where he felt like there was a stronger need within his laboratory. So he was able to move those resources around, which really helped him. And he'll talk probably more about that during his presentation. Also within program summary, there's a section called document control. As I talked about accreditation, if you know anything about accreditation, it's all about documentation, 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 not location, location, location. So within the FIDO program, it's recommended that the agencies establish a list of documents that are utilized in the FIDO program or associated with it. And then once you have a list of documents and utilize those documents, there should be a review of all those operational documents just as required in an accreditation program. And that should occur annually, just as everything else within this program should be reviewed annually, just to make sure that everything is working the way it's supposed to and the way it was structured. The section talks about management oversight. It's recommended that a FIDO program should have an organizational command structure. Someone should be in charge of your FIDO program within the particular agency. There should be written position requirements that summarize individual responsibilities, duties, and make sure there's proper delegation of authority. The quality of field drug testing services is contingent upon the commitment of all personnel to integrity, impartiality, and competence. It's almost an ethics statement for a FIDO program, if you will. The second subsection under the first large section of summary administration is called program administration. This provides a framework which has the quality guidance in areas of program auditing, deficiency identification, corrective action initiation and monitoring, laboratory assessments, and remedial training efforts. Once again, this is set up kind of as a structure of an accreditation program. If you're familiar with accreditation, if you're familiar with corrective actions, if you're familiar with deficiency identifications, that's all from the terminology of accreditation there. But it gives a strong quality presence within the program so that if there is an issue, there's mechanisms in place to identify that there's an issue, how it can be addressed, how it can be followed up on, how it can all be documented so that it shows the quality issues within the program. Other program administration subsection, auditing guidelines, defining deficiency, corrective action procedures, suspension and reinstatement, hopefully that never happens, and the training syllabus. Training documentation records, remedial training, review and assessment, program reporting and evaluation, legal environment, and considerations. These are all subsections within the program administration section of the first part. A little bit about auditing guidelines. These are recommended again. Periodic auditing and monitoring are required tools utilized to ensure continued compliance with accepted quality procedures. And the drug field testing unit should establish an annual procedure for the auditing of field test operations to include the review of testing methods, laboratory assessment review, and the storage control of all program documents. Once again, basically accreditation type language within the program. Corrective action procedures. A corrective action process is implemented and documented whenever nonconformities from accepted field testing practices are indicated. Causation, of course, is a big part of corrective action. It's the first step. And there should always be a process to review, including a process review to include training processes, field testing procedures, controls and standard requirements, and employee performance may be required. This is all part of a corrective action process for those of you that are familiar with how corrective action works. There's a section about review and assessment of the FIDO program, making sure that management reviews the program to ensure that the results, all the reports, and supporting documentation are reviewed to make sure things are being done properly and done as recommended. Reviews are conducted to verify that conclusions that are drawn are supported by documentation and that conclusions are deemed as scientifically appropriate. This goes back to basically a laboratory type analysis and what type of information is required in a laboratory analysis. So we recommended that the FIDO program have the same sort of issues as far as reviews went. The guide recommends a couple or several different methods of review and verification. Technical case review is done within laboratories, which is basically a review of notes, data, and other documents that form the basis for a scientific conclusion. There's an administrative case review, which is basically just a review of consistency with testing policy, testing a report, or looking at the reports for editorial correctness. And then there's a laboratory analysis of a percentage of field test cases. We recommended 10% of each testing officer's cases quarterly. You will hear from Nancy that they've dropped theirs down to about 5%. You can actually set the standards however you want them. These are, like I said, just our recommended. But we recommended, maybe at the beginning especially, you know, if you start a FIDO program, you want to do 10% of the officer's cases just to make sure that they are doing the testing correctly as a follow-up. It's a quality control measure again. There's documentation review on evidence handling, chain of custody, evidence package, initial and evidence description, and then analytical documentation. The testing procedures were followed as laid out, observations were documented, and results of the field testing were properly documented. All right, we're moving into the second section, which is training program elements. Several subsections within this part, personnel requirements, performance standards, evidence control, report preparation, and quality control. Lesson plans, class outlines, recertification class lesson plans, class lectures, presentations, practical exercises, written examinations, and practical assessments. Training program in a box, for lack of a better word to say it. And as I said, I'm not going into the training section because Joan and Kirk are going to spend a great deal of time talking about the different sections of training parts. They're going to show you some of the different presentations that are involved, the lesson plans, the practical assessments, practical exercises. So we're not going to go to that. Third section is about forms. It has several subsections: field drug testing report, request for field drug tests, adult audit quality review report, corrective action report, and technical case review. All of these forms are templates. They're put there just as an example of a form that you might want to adopt. The information that might be want to be included in a form, even if you adopted one of your own forms or changed your own form to meet your particular needs within the FIDO program. So these are simply templates presented for review, presented for reference if somebody wanted to utilize them. As I said, the field drug test report provided is an example of a templated form. Form is very generic. It's just used to illustrate some of the necessary information to be captured when performing field tests for suspected controlled substances. There's a technical case review form, as we talked about technical case review as it applies. Once again, it's a templated form. It's very generic and is illustrated to use some of the necessary information that should be captured when performing a supervisory technical review of field tests. The last section within the FIDO program is references. And there are several subsections: reference information, the presumptive field test kit evaluation, and an evidence operational policy. Once again, the evidence operational policy is simply a templated form given as an example of the type of information that might be needed. The presumptive field test kit evaluation, just to speak a little bit about that, and I think Kirk's going to go into great detail about that. But when we were actually putting FIDO together, we looked around and no one had ever done an evaluation, or what we considered to be a comprehensive evaluation, of commercially available field test kits. There had been some studies done by NIJ, but nothing that we consider to be comprehensive that looked into a number of different factors that might affect those kits as they were being used in the field. So we went to great pains to put together this presumptive field test kit evaluation using, I believe, the four most common purchased commercially available kits. Kirk will go into great detail about how that evaluation was structured, kind of what the results were, all the different parameters that we used as we went through this. As you'll see, it was quite a comprehensive evaluation of those test kits. And it is actually included within the FIDO program on the disk, and you can actually see the evaluation, see all the different tests that were made, all the different parameters that were used. We've also included just hyperlinks or different website information actually within the reference sections, like DEA's website, the ONDCP's website, Drug Identification Bible, drugid.org, and there are several others. And I think there's about 12 or 15 references within that section total, where you can go and get additional information if needed. Ah, didn't know this was in here. Forgot my own presentation. Like I said, this is just a little bit about the presumptive field test kit evaluations. And talks about the results of the study demonstrated that the detection kits are an adequate method for on-the-scene presumptive analysis of suspected controlled substances. And once again, you'll hear more about this evaluation as Kurt presents it later on today. And once again, we have my contact information. All right. Questions about kind of the program structure, how the program is laid out, any of the sections or subsections or anything within it. And like I said, hopefully during the course, I don't know how many of you brought computers with you. I never know of anybody that goes anywhere without a computer anymore. But maybe you'll have some time, or if you have a specific question, hunt me down later today. And if you want to, we can pull up the actual program off the thumb drive and you know, look at something off of it. But maybe if you have a chance later this afternoon or tonight, you can actually look at it on your computer back at the hotel. So, questions? Anything at all? Okay.